Good evening and heartfelt welcome this evening to our Wednesday night fellowship. We are live on online church on Facebook and Facebook. And tonight we are conducting our service bilingually in English and in Afrikaans. And I'll be ministering in English. My name is Stanley and my wife will be primarily ministering in Afrikaans. That's actually our home language, our first language, our mother tongue. And she is Karen.
Goeienaand almal. Wow, wat 'n opgewondenheid om vanaand weer hier te wees saam met u. Dit is 'n een keertjie uitgesit. Dit was nie lekker nie. Maar ek is bly om vanaand weer hier te wees om saam met u te kuier. En ag, dit is 'n lekker onderwerp wat ons vanaand gaan bespreek, dink ek. Dink ons gaan dit almal vreeslik baie geniet en wees deel daarvan. Share dit dan na jou tydlyn toe. Na jou status toe, en dan kan allemaal ook deel wees daarvan, loof die Here.
Yes, good evening, welcome, welcome. We're just giving the opportunity here for everybody to tune in live, to have fellowship with us, you with us, we with you, we with the Lord. Yes, goeienaand allemaal. Please share the message there to your Facebook timeline, just tap that share button, click share, and there it goes. And also to your WhatsApp status, very effective. Afterwards, we do upload a video to a YouTube channel with the same name, as well as in a Telegram channel with the same name.
Yes,
yes, because sometimes we don't have the other social platforms, or we can't listen to the audio in a WhatsApp group. Then you can listen to the audio in a Telegram group, as well as watch the videos if you want to belong there. Please do contact us and then we can give you the proper link.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How are you today? Yeah, we in Langebaan, South Africa. In the 5 years that we've been living here, today was the very first day we had some hail.
Yep.
We never had hail before. Actually, lightning, thunderstorms and hail, but fortunately hail wasn't that big. It was small pieces and it was quick, over quickly, because our car, you are standing outside. So we are just glad for the Lord in that respect as well. So hallelujah, praise the Lord, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Just let us just glorify the Lord this evening.
Amen, praise the Lord.
Yes, amen. Wow, we are so privileged. We thank the Lord as well for Susan Creel's leg that are healing so easily. Yes, easily. So beautifully. At the time, I thought to myself, "Yoh, Lord." But I know the very first time when we went to Susan, she said, "I believe the Lord can heal me quicker than what a doctors can say."
Yes.
And it seems to me it's going to happen.
Yes.
And it's busy happening, actually. Ja, so Susan se been, wat sy nou so ruk, so tykie terug. Joh, dis ook nie al 2-3 maande gelede.
Ja, geval.
Geval, lelik beseer. Was so erg gewees, hulle moes op 'n stadium 'n veloorplanting gedoen het. En haar been genees verskriklik mooi. Wow, dis net wonderlik om te sien hoe die Here ook haar op haar ouderdom, dat hy genesing so mooi deurbreek op haar been. Prys die naam van die Here. Ja, wel ons, baie keer, ek kyk hier die foto so skepties, dan sê sy, ek glo dat die Here my spoedig kan genees, sy het vertroue van die begin af gehad, en ja, prys die Here, en die Here is regtig besig, en ons wil die Here ook net dankie sê, Jan, haar man, dat haar so mooi bystaan, en ook haar ondersteun in elke opsig.
Wow, prys die Here, dis amazing, ons gaan ook vanavond vir Rina bid, sy het gevra vir gebed, sy is glad nie lekker nie, so ons gaan ook saam bid vanavond vir Rina. Loof die Here. Is daar nog iemand wat gebed nodig het? Wat?
Hoe gaan het met Michelle? Is al beter?
Michelle is beter, Michelle is heel op die been, sy shop shop.
Yes.
Goeie naand aan Hamel, Delport is terug by die huis. Ons is blij die Delport is terug by die huis, veilig. Loof die Here. Prys die Here vir genesing.
Amen.
Ja, so as daar enig iemand is wat gebed nodig het vanavond, sê dit vir ons al, is dit op WhatsApp, as jy dit ook nie op die comments wil sit nie, dan kan ons ook vanavond saam met jou bid, loof die Here.
Wow, amazing, 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 that we can serve the Lord in this
Amen.
Way, yes. Hallelujah. And When we see how the Lord is working in people's lives, how He is providing for them in their health and in their circumstances, we just are in front of the Lord all the time. We have such a hope and faith in the Lord. Doesn't matter how hopeless our situation and life is, if we really serve the Lord with everything in our heart, then He eventually will help us, that we don't come despondent, we don't become despaired and lose faith. Because that's the main thing. At the end of the day, is to lose, we must not lose faith, hope. Sure. Yes.
Dis so mooi, my man, dat hy skryf wat Kitty ook gedeel het. Ons moet met geduld aangaan.
Yes.
Is dit nie mooi nie? Sjoe, dit het my baie bemoedig. Geduld.
Geduld, geduld.
Vrede, geduld.
Yes.
Wag op die Here. Dis die moeilikste ding wat 'n mens in jou lewe kan doen, is om te wag op die Here vir 'n antwoord. En so ons moet met daai geduld voor die Here wees. Dis net so, so super cool.
Yes, amen.
Wow, praise the Lord.
Okay, we're going to talk this evening about the royal law. What is the royal law? I think you know what is the royal law. But it's also always a very interesting topic to discuss and just to talk it through. Because we know the royal law is not just about words. It's an action. We can teach each other and help each other and remind each other regarding the royal law. But at the end of the day, it is our duty to act upon that.
Ja, so ons gaan vanavond oor die koninklike wet gesels. Nou, jy weet seker wat die koninklike wet is, maar dit het my so getref volgend. Ons het so vir babietjie gaan optel volgend en toe ons in die kar ry, toe luister ons die Bybel en dit het my so getref toe ek weer hoor van die koninklike wet. Joch, dit is so mooi en dit is nie net woorde nie, dit is 'n aksie, dit is iets wat jy moet uitvoer in jou lewe. So ek denk vanavond kan dit net weer so bietjie meer duidelik seker in die mense lewe maak. Dit het weer ons sommer soveel antwoorde gegee op baie dinge. So ons loof die Here dat ons dit ook vanavond met u kan deel.
Yes, amen. But before we're going to get there, let's open with prayer or start with prayer. Not open, we already opened, start with prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And once again, we have the privilege to Father, minister and encourage our brothers and sisters and minister your word, Father. And we also have the hope, we also have the faith. Yeah. Lord, that when we minister here live on air and even afterwards, Father, you can direct a sinner, the one who has never given his life or her life to the Lord, that they can tune in and understand something and they can open their hearts so to become a child of you, Father, to serve thee and to breakthrough in Lord in their lives, because a lot of people, they are despondent, they, Father, are despaired, and they think they know you, they think they're a child of thee, they might be a churchgoer, they might be in name a Christian or not, Father, but this evening you can use this message over the airs, across the globe, across the world, to reach a sinner, to reach the lost, and also most important as well, Father, is to encourage and Father your children, Lord, Father, want u kinders, Here, u stuur u engele uit vir die dienswerk van u kinders, Here, en ons is ook daarom u kinders te leer, te onderrig, Father, te help, Here, en leiding te gee. Dit is net so 'n groot deel van die evangelie. Father, all our gifts, when you talk about the gifts, it's also to minister to the brotherhood and to care for them, and Father, so they can receive help and admonishment, and that they can receive answers in their life, so that they can serve you in spirit and truth. And we thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Ons wil vanaand ook vir Rina bid. En ek wil vir die dankie sê, Here my God, hallelujah, dat ons altyd na u toe kan kom. Die woord gee vir ons die opening, die woord gee vir ons die, Here, die reg vir ons lees in die woord, Vader, om in alle nederigheid na u toe te kom en met u te praat oor ons medebroers en susters. Volgende, toe ek so in die Bybel luister, of gisteroggend op een plek, was Paulus so opgewonde om te sê, bid vir ons en ons sal vir julle bid. Vader, ons moet vir mekaar bid. Ja, ons moet mekaar, Vader, werkelijk waar voor die aangezig van u noem, in ons gebede, ja, in ons hart, Heere, Vader. Die broeders moet in ons wees, in ons hart wees, ons hart moet verruim wees, om vir hulle te kan bid. En vanavond wil ons vir Rina bid, en vraag dat u ook haar sal genees, en dat u ook haar sal lichamelik sal oprig, Vader. Ons weet, in die wintertijd is het baie keer moeilik vir die lichaam, daar is soveel dinge, vir al die wat ouder is, die wat Heere probleem in hulle lichaam het, is asof het dan op sy ergste kop uitsteek.
Ja,
en ons wil bid, Vader, dat u haar genees, en elkeen wat vanavond siek is, ons denk aan Michelle ook, Vader, dat jy ook volkom en volmaak sal genees,
ja,
Vader.
Ja.
En ons sê vir die baie, baie dankie, Vader. I pray also for my wife and myself, that you will guide us this evening and lead us. We've prepared this message. But Father, at the end of the day, our words, our thinking, our Father guidance come from you by the power of your Holy Spirit. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And I pray that you will help us this evening.
Amen.
We are really in help of thee, Father.
Thank
it's a big
you.
Topic. Father, the royal law. We know it is, it's all, Father, it's what the gospel is about.
Yeah.
And Father, we don't want to break it down or,
yes,
Father, water it down, Lord, or minister this evening in ignorance. But Father, according to your wisdom, of your spirit in us. And I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Father. Ek wil vanavond vir baie dankie sê, dat ons net voor jou aangezig kan wees. Wat een geweldige voorrecht. Heere, toe my man vanavond so bid, ons moet in nederigheid voor u kom. Te besef ek, Heere, ons harte moet voor u verneder, Heere. Ons moet so afhankelijk wees van u, Vader. En vanavond, Heere, ervaar ek die afhankelijkheid van u, om net, Heere, te praat wat u wil hee ons moet praat, te deel wat u wil hee ons moet deel. Heere, wat een voorreg, Heere, om die woord met ons medebroers en sisters te mag deel. Heere, om ons kossies weer op die regte tyd uit te deel vir mekaar, om sekerheid te hee, standvastigheid, om beweeglikheid in die woord van u, om weer ons dienswerk verder te kan doen, Heere. Baie, baie dankie daarvoor, en ek wil ook bid, Heere, Ruida en Michelle vir jaar môre. Ach Heere, en ek wil bid vir hulle Vader, dat u krachtig vir hulle deurbreek, dat u hulle versterk in die jaar wat voorlê, dat u Heere my God vir hulle God van nabij sal wees. Ek besef Heere, die druk op die vrouens is geweldig. Heere, in werksituasies Heere, en in baie dinge, Heere, verantwoordelikheid in huise en so aan. En daarom bid ek Heere, dat u hulle wysheid sal gee, insig sal gee, al die liefde wat hulle nodig het, Heere, toe en teenoor allemaal, om dit net uit te leef, Vader. Baie, baie dankie daarvoor, Heere, ons loof en ons prys, dat hulle mamas vir hulle kinders, Heere, kan wees, en vrouens vir hulle mans, en ach, Heere, dat u net krachtig vir hulle deurbreek, Heere, dat u net, Vader, in hierdie jaar hulle sal sien, in elke liewe situasie in hulle lewe, elke gebed, elke uitroepe, Heere, elke traan, Vader, wat voor u gestort word, in hulle harte wil ons net bid, Heere, dat u sal antwoord, dat u sal luister, Vader, en dat u krachtig sal deurbreek, Vader. Daar is behoefte en daar is baie situasies, Heere, en ons roep u aan vanaand, dat u krachtig sal deurbreek, Vader. Ons wil ook bid vir ons medebroers en sisters, Heere, ons besef, Vader is weer die einde van die maand, Heere, daar is baie verpligtinge en dinge, en ons wil u aanroep dat u sal voorsien, Heere, dat u sal help, dat u, Heere, krachtig sal deurbreek en sal voorsien in elke een se situasie, Vader. Ons wil, Heere, u net aanroep vanavond, Vader, dit is net vir my so 'n heerlikheid om net te kan weet, ons kan alles met u praat, met u deel, vir u vra, Heere, in u, Heere, teenwoordigheid net wees vanavond, Vader, om versterking te kry, Heere, om net te kan weet, Vader, u weet van ons, u is ons Vader, ons is in u huis, ons kan met u praat, ons kan, Heere, ons harte voor u uitstort, wat 'n heerlikheid, wat 'n voorreg, en ons sê vir u so baie dankie daarvoor, en ons wil net vir mekaar bid vanavond, Heere, asseblief, Vader, dat u krachtig sal deurbreek en sal help en voorsien, Heere, in elke situasie, ons loof en ons prys, geef my en my man asseblief vanaand die wysheid en die insig, Here, om net Vader die woorde kan bedien, Vader, asseblief in u wysheid. Here, wil ons vanaand praat. Here, ons kan baie woorde sê wat dalk die woord van u kan afbreek, wat dit Here kan kragteloos maak, maar ons wil nie, Here, ons wil in reinheid en waarheid en wysheid die woord van u bedien en ons sê net vanaand vir u so baie dankie dat u ons net daarmee help in die kragtige naam van u seun Jesus Christus. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. For his wisdom tonight. Amen. We need the wisdom of the Lord. When we are talking about the royal law, now the royal law is the law of love. That is the fulfillment of the word of God.
Amen.
And through Jesus Christ, by the spiritual rebirth, we receive the Holy Spirit. And so we receive love of God in our hearts. And that is a privilege that God bestows on us when we are born again. It's the gift that we received from the Father in Jesus' name.
Wow, is it not amazing? So die koninklike wet is liefde. En alles, die hele wet is vervul in liefde. In die Here Jesus Christus, toe hy gesterf het en opgestaan het. Is dit nie amazing nie? Want toe kan daar vergifnis wees. Toe kan daar die gees van die Here weer in ons harte uitgestort word. Daar kan weer wedergeboorte plaasgevind het.
Amen.
Waarmee ons die gees van die Here kan ontvang om weer te verander na die beeld van God. Is dit nie amazing wat God se liefde vir ons gedoen het nie? Sjoe, toe ek vandag daaraan dink, toe dink ek, Here, dit is so groot, dit is so mooi en heerlik en alles het in die Here Jesus Christus gebeur. Wow. So ja, dit is net vir my 'n opgewondenheid vanaand.
Yes, but most of the time, of all the time, when we think of love and we want to talk about love, the reference chapter in scripture is 1 Corinthians 13. Now, 1 Corinthians 13, the whole chapter, describe love to us. And even in that, it's way more than that. Because it's like a condensed form. And as you read through the entire word, it elaborates on a lot of those points to understand it better, isn't it so?
Ja, so ja, as ons aan liefde, as ons aan liefde denk, dan denk ons dadelijk aan 1 Corinthians 13. Het vat alles van liefde so mooi saam. En dit beskryf dit so mooi, maar dit is nog groter as dit. Dit is so amazing. Ons sukkel om liefde te verstaan. So, ons gaan vanaand so 'n bietjie lekker daaroor gesels en so 'n bietjie uitbrei daarop. Dat ons net weer so 'n bietjie kan sekerheid kry en herinner kan word aan wat is hierdie wet van liefde wat God vir ons gegee het in die Nuwe Testament. Dit gaan nie meer oor die Ou Testament nie.
Yes,
want die 10 gebooie het in vervulling gekom in liefde.
Yes.
Is dit nie amazing nie, in die Here Jesus Christus. So ja, dit is waarin ons nou wandel, dit is waarin ons nou lewe, dit is die wet, dit is die koninklike wet wat God vir ons gegee het.
Ja, if you look at the Ten Commandments, actually the Ten Commandments are 10 points that also describes love, because it describes the love towards God, how to serve Him, love towards your fellow brother and sister and human being on earth. And also, that is basically it. Actually wanted to say something else, but not now, as yet. But that is the two main things. And this is what Jesus Christ said. He says the love, and this is in the Bible, there's two laws, but the two laws is one law. The love towards God and the love towards your fellow human being must be exactly the same.
Sure. So, it's
it's worded in two sentences, but it's one thing.
Yeah. Sure. So, that's alike. Sure.
Yes, because we cannot love God and hate our fellow human being and brother and sister, and vice versa. It's impossible.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Why? Because God is love, isn't it so? God is love. So, when we talk about God, we talk about God, and that is the challenge that we have, and that is the trembling in our hearts for tonight's service ministry.
Ja, so God is liefde, en liefde is hy, en hy is die grootste, en dit is hoekom ons vanavond so benauwd is om ook hierdie boodskap te bedien, want liefde is God, dit is sy hele wese is liefde, en hy is vir altyd, hy kan nie vergaan nie, hy kan nie uitgewis word nie. So liefde kan nooit ooit uitgewis word nie, want God is liefde. En niks is groter as God nie. Is dit nie amazing nie? So hy is vir ewig. En hy is al die almagtige koning. Hy is die koning wat vir ons die wet kom gee het om te volg. Yes. Om gehoorsaam te wees. Is dit nie mooi nie? Yes. Hy is die koning wat het vir ons kom gee het. Dis is ook wat 'n koninklike wet is. Wow.
Now when we read in 1 Corinthians 13, we read, love is the greatest.
Yes.
Love never ends. The word it also uses fails, never come to an end. Now, it's also the royal law. When we read in James 2, verse 8, we read about the royal law. When we adhere to the royal law.
Sure.
Now, God is love. He is the greatest. He will never end. He will never cease to exist. And God the Father is the eternal, almighty King.
Wow.
Isn't that amazing to think of it? So that is how big love is.
That's amazing.
Actually, there is no words to describe it, but we must describe it to understand something.
Ja, ons moet dit so verstaan volgens die woord van die Here. En as mens dit so aanneem en toepas, dan breek dit in jou hart deur. En God is nog groter as dit. En dit is wat ons vanaand sê, jy kan nie by die grootheid van God kom nie. Maar tog as mens verstaan wat liefde is, dan kan mens al by dit begin uitkom.
Ja,
in daai reinheid en lewe, joh.
Ja, ons kan baie van eienskappe begin toepas, né?
Sure.
Now, first of all, before we're going to continue, there's something that we must keep in mind when we talk about love and that God is love. Now, God is holy. We must always keep it in mind. God is holy. Therefore, love is holy.
Yeah.
God does not love and desire the things of this material world.
Yes.
He has no desire for material wealth. He has no desire to do sin. Therefore, love, the love of God, has no desire to do the sinful things of this world. And therefore, love is holy. We must always bear that in mind when we talk about love. And love, God's love, is not a love for this world, the pleasures, the desires for this world.
So, as ons aan liefde denk, moet ons verstaan dat liefde heilig is, want God is heilig. Liefde is rein, want God is rein. God het geen begeerte of drang na hierdie wêreld, na sonde, na begeertes, na materialisme, na enige iets op hierdie aarde nie. God het geen begeerte daarna nie, want hy sê so mooi, hy sê as ons 'n begeerte het na die wêreld, raak ons 'n vyand van hom. So hy het geen begeerte om enige iets op hierdie aarde te besit of te wil hê nie. En hy's rein en hy's heilig en dit is wat liefde is. So ons moet dit in gedagte hou terwyl ons van liefde praat.
Yes, now, let's go to the royal law scripture. That is in James 2, verse 8. And let us just see more or less in what context this is written as well. That is James 2, verse 8, Jacobus 2, verse 8. So let us read there. Okay, but I think, okay, let us read verse 8 and then we're going to read verse 9. If you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. You do well.
Sure.
But if you show partiality, you commit sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors.
Sure.
So the royal law, if we are partial. Now, if you're going to read from verse 1, we see a situation are described. Here is a James gives us an example. If you are gathered together, now he's talking to the children of God. When they gather together, we are now in church, like as we understand this church, and you see, wow, this is this rich man coming in, and you behave more cunningly,
sure,
better towards the rich man, and are more friendly and reach out to the rich man than the poor man, you are partial.
Hmm.
You are then a respecter of a person. And God is not a respecter of a person. God accepts both equally or rejects both equally if they refuse to repent and sort out their life with the Lord. And then, through the royal law, if we are partial, if we are a respecter of a person, then we are convicted as transgressors.
Sure. Jakobus 2 vers 8. As jy ewenwel die koninklike wet volbring, volgens die skrif, jy met jou naaste lief hê soos jouself, dan doen jy goed. Maar as jy partydig is, doen jy sonde en word weer die wet oor as oortreders bestraf. So hierso het Jakobus 'n situasie vir ons geskep dat daar kom twee mense in die kerk en een is ryk en een is arm. En die ryk persoon gee jy die voorkeur. Jy laat hom op die beter sitplek sit. En die arm persoon moet sommer daar onder die voetbank gaan sit. So daar's partyskap in jou hart en volgens die koninklike wet is dit nie mooi nie. Kan daai partyskap nie in jou hart wees nie, dan is jy 'n oortreder en jy word bestraf as 'n oortreder. En die koninklike wet van liefde is onpartydig want in God se hart is daar geen partyskap nie. Wanneer 'n persoon die Here Jesus Christus aanneem in die wedergeboorte, 'n kind van God word, dan wys God niemand af as gevolg van wie die persoon is nie.
Yes.
Hy neem die persoon van 'n mens nie aan nie.
Yes,
so elkeen wat sy hart hom aanneem, wat oopmaak, wat hom kom verneder voor sy aangesig, daai persoon neem hy aan, yes. Of hy verstoot hulle, wat nie hom aanneem nie. So daar is geen partyskap in God se hart oor arm of ryk of status of ras of taal of nasie of wat ook al die geval mag wees nie. So wanneer ons partyskap het, dan doen ons sonde, want dit is nie volgens die koninklike wet wat ingeskryf is nie.
Wow, and just by this we can already see that the love that if we say we love God, we must love everybody as God loves that person.
Sure.
And yeah, already we can see something about the real nature, if I can put it like that,
sure,
of love. Then it's the real nature of God. And it is how we act. We show our love by how we act and think in our hearts towards a fellow human being.
Ja, ja, so ons liefde word gewys. Dit is die bewys wat ons lewer wanneer ons optree.
Yes.
Met ons medebroer en suster of die sondaar of wat ook al die geval mag wees. So dan wys ons wat in ons harte is. En dit is so mooi om aan te dink. God se liefde is so rein en heilig en dit is wat ons ontvang van God af. Nou as ons dit nie aanneem nie, gaan ons dit nie uitleef nie. Het jy al daaraan gedink? Ons moet dit aanneem, ons moet dit deel van ons lewe maak. En hoe word jy deel van dit? Wanneer jy jou hart vir die Here gee. Jy kan nie deel raak van God se liefde wanneer jy nog nie jou hart vir die Here gegee het nie. Want dan word die Gees van die Here in jou uitgestort. Gawes word in jou uitgestort, sy liefde word in jou uitgestort en dan kan jy begin deel raak van God se liefde en ook hierdie eienskappe begin uitleef.
Right, to receive, to start walking, to receive love and to act upon love, we must receive the Lord, we must acknowledge Him. If we are born again, we give our heart to the Lord, we are born again, then we receive that love. Then only we can act according to that love. Now, what is quite amazing, I just want to clarify this point here in James 2 verses 8. He's talking about love your neighbor as yourself. And yeah, we must understand. Yeah, He spoke to or wrote to children of God. Now, we as children of God, we are also one another's neighbor. We are neighbors of each other. We have neighborly love, we have brotherly love, and in the body of Christ as well. That's why he quotes here, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Because here he was speaking to the children of God, how they act towards each other. This is the main topic here.
Ja, so hier het Jakobus geskryf vir die kinders van die Here. En wanneer jy die Here dien, saam met jou broers en susters, is hulle ook jou naaste.
Yeah.
So hier moet ons verstaan, dit gaan oor kinders van die Here se optrede. Maar dit gaan oor teenoor mekaar, die broederskap teenoor mekaar en ook die sondaar.
Yeah. Yes.
So dit gaan nie net hier oor die son daar nie. Dit gaan hier oor ons is mekaar se broer en suster, ons is mekaar se naaste. En almal wat die Here dien in die liggaam van Christus is mekaar se naaste. En dan brei dit ook uit na almal buite dit.
Yeah, if you just think about Jesus Christ, when he was on earth, he was among the Jews, but according to the law of the New Testament, the fulfillment, the new covenant, no one were saved in the Old Testament. There were no saved, born-again persons. While Jesus was on earth, it was still the Old Testament time. So everybody was sinners. And he behaved and towards everybody in exactly the same way. Even he acted towards Judas Iscariot exactly in the same way as the rest of the apostles. The Pharisees, he acted in the same way as the poorest beggar that he met in the street. So there was no partiality and respecter of person in Jesus Christ's heart, whether they followed him or whether they didn't follow him.
Ja, dit is baie mooi. So daar was geen partijskap in Jesus' hart, terwyl hy op aarde was nie. Hy het allemaal dieselfde hanteer. Is dit nie mooi nie? Even vir Judas Iscariot, dat die mede disciples eers geweet het, dat Judas Iscariot die geld steel of die geldbeers verkeerd hanteer nie. So Jesus het nooit daar oor gepraat nie, hy het nooit beskimp nie. En hy het allemaal wat na hom toe gekom het, dieselfde hanteer. Allemaal wat om iets gevra het, het hy gehelp. Is dit nie mooi nie? Hy het niemand weggewys nie. So dit is net mooi om aan te denk dat daar is geen partijskap in Godse koninkryk nie. En allemaal was nog sondaars. En want Jesus Christus, terwyl hy op aarde was, was nog die Ou Testament gewees. So niemand kon nog tot bekering kom, gered word, uitsorteer, gees van die Here ontvang het en so aan nie. So, even met die sondaar het hy met allemaal dieselfde opgetree, of hy hom nou gevolg het en of hy hom nie gevolg het nie, het hy allemaal dieselfde behandel.
I just want to clarify this point with my wife. He said, only after Judas hanged himself, then they realized what Judas actually did all the time.
Yeah.
And then it came out.
Yes.
But while they were all there in one accord, living together with each other, nobody really knew what Judas Iscariot's motive was in his heart to such an extent, the very last minute when Jesus Christ said, go out and do what you want to do, they did not even expect it, the faintest idea that Judas would go out and betray Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Wow, isn't that amazing?
Ja, so eers daar dat dit gebeur het, het allemaal eindelijk besef wat het gebeur. So, terwyl hulle saam was, het niemand ooit geweet wat Judas se plan of se saak was nie.
Yes.
Maar na die tyd het dit uitgekom. Dit het allemaal verstaan waaroor dit gegaan het.
Yes, so in all that time, okay, we're going to get there. I don't want to run the message. Okay, now let's go jump back to 1 Corinthians 13. Summary of love. Let's go back there. 1 Corinthians 13.
Ons gaan terug na 1 Corinthians 13 toe. Die hele opsomming van liefde.
Yeah, it's actually, let us just read the first three verses. We're going to read a whole chapter, but not just quick points we want to, just a quick things we want to point out. And then there's one specific word in verse 7 we want to elaborate a little bit more on. But the rest we're just going to run it through quickly. But let's read from verse 1 in 1 Corinthians 13. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but I have not love, I become a sounding brass and a clanging cymbal. And we already can see we receive God's love at our spiritual rebirth. But afterwards, we can deviate from that love. We can fall back from that love. Isn't it so? By just being partial. That's it. The rest of the sin, you don't even do it anymore. Just being partial, a respecter of a person, you transgress the law of love.
1 Corinthians 13 vers 1, al sou ek die tale van mense en engele spreek, en ek het nie die liefde nie, dan het ek 'n klinkende metaal of 'n lydende simbool geword. So hier sien ons, dat met ons wedergeboorte het ons die liefde van God ontvang, sy gees ontvang, maar ons kan terugsak, ons kan wegval, en dan kan ons al hierdie dinge doen, eintlik in 'n teruggevalle toestand.
Yes.
So dan beteken dit niks meer nie. Yes. Dan is dit soos hierdie klinkende metaal en hierdie lydende sibil.
Yeah, so while we carrying on with willful partiality, we can do all these things and it's going to help us nothing. Let us read verse 2 and 3. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profits me nothing. So it is a very serious thing to understand that we must abide in love and we must stay in that love. And this is what Jesus Christ said. We are the branches. He is the vine. And the branch must stay in the vine for the branch to bear fruit. If it doesn't stay in the vine, it won't bear fruit. It's logical. It makes logical sense to us. And this is what he is describing to us. We must stay in the love as going to be described. Otherwise, whatever we do, we can do charity. It means nothing.
Sure. Al sou ek die taal van profesie en al die geheimenisse weet en al die kennis en dan sou ek al die geloof hê sodat ek berge kon versit. En ek het nie die liefde nie, dan sou ek niks wees nie. Al sou ek my goed uitdeel en al sou ek my liggaam oorgee om verbrand te word. En ek het nie die liefde nie, dan sou dit my niks baat nie. So ons moet in die liefde bly. Dit is 'n baie baie ernstige saak hierdie, om in die liefde te bly, so dat my werke daarna iets kan beteken.
Ja.
So.
Wow. Now, love suffers long. Okay. Kan ons gou terug gaan daar na die... Now we're going to go over to verse 4. He says, love suffers long and is kind. Love doesn't envy. Love doesn't parade itself. He's not puffed up. But let us just stand still at these words, these instructions, what love is about.
Ja, so ons gaan net na 'n paar woorde kyk wat hier van vers 4 afkom, dat ons net so 'n bietjie 'n perspektief daaroor kry. Net ek dink net nou daaraan dat al hierdie dinge word saamgevat in die koninklike wet.
Yes.
So as ons na hierdie woorde kyk en ons verstaan waar 1 Korintiërs 13 gaan, dan verstaan ons al 'n groot deel van waaroor die koninklike wet gaan. Want dit val alles hier onder. Dit is die vleisies van dit, om dit so te verstaan.
Dit is mooi gestel.
Ja, al die vleisies.
Yes. So, 1 Corinthians 13 describes the royal law. So, let us just look at a few things regarding the royal law. Now, the first thing in verse 4, it says it suffers long. In other words, that suffers long, it's not quick-tempered, does not act hastily, is patient. So, that is the first thing. And God is patient. And this is what he said. I am patient. And the one who believes is not quick. He's not hastily. So we must be patient. So whatever we do in the Lord and in the gospel and ask the Lord and serve him, there must be long suffering in us. We must not be quick tempered.
So die liefde is lankmoedig. Sê die liefde is nie hastig nie. Net om dit te verstaan is amazing. Whatever jy bid, whatever jy van die Here af vra, whatever jy doen in die evangelie, jy moenie hastig wees nie. Jy moet lankmoedig wees.
Wow. Ja, in hierdie opvleende geaardheid van ons. If somebody is iemand ons teestaan, is iemand iets vir ons sê, hy vinnige, bitsige geaardheid.
Ja, bitsigheid.
Hy bitsigheid.
Ja, want as jy nie haastig is nie, sal jy vredevol wees. So jy sal luister, jy sal vol vrede wees en iemand mooi antwoord. Of jy sal net wag op die Here. En dis die moeilikste in die evangelie. Ja. Daai wag, daai lankmoedigheid, om nie hastig te wees nie, om nie aan te val nie, om nie bitsig te wees nie, om nie in te chip nie, en al daai dinge. So dit is alles wat hy hiervan praat, om lankmoedig te wees.
Yes, and we want everything just like that in the world. And we sometimes walk around and brag about our nature. I am this quick person. I can think on my feet. I can just do the things. And it's nothing, and it has nothing to do with the gospel. Because when you start serving the Lord is long-suffering over us as well. Because if long-suffering is part and parcel of love, God is also long-suffering.
Sure.
Yes, he's not quick-tempered.
Baie keer roem ons oor ons geaardheid wat so vinnig is en wat op jou voete kan dink en wat dinge kan doen en so aan. Maar in God is dit nie so nie. So die geaardheid waarin jy roem het niks met liefde te doen nie. So ja, as mens dit so ook al kan verstaan, is dit nogal 'n groot saak.
Now the next one is quite amazing to me. That is, love is kind. Now in Afrikaans, you will only find the word vriendelik that we understand is friendly. But what is kind? That word love is kind means show yourself useful.
Sure.
Show yourself useful. In other words, that is to help others by not reminding them of their weakness and or situation and telling it or revealing it to others. So that is very important. When you must show yourself useful and help someone without reminding or telling them, let them feel they are weak or telling it to others. That is what that kind means. So in other words, it's a friendliness in your heart, a willingness that you want to help others. You want to show yourself useful to others.
Sure, so I brought you van vriendelik. So dis om jouself beskikbaar te stel.
Yes.
En om ander te help. En sonder dat hulle voel, hulle is useless. Of sonder om vir hulle te laat voel, hulle is swak. En dit ook aan ander oor te vertel. Ek moes nou vir hierdie en dit doen, want daai en daai kon nou nie. En dit is wat ons so graag in wil roem. En dis wat die woord so mooi van praat. Hy praat eintlik so mooi om ons harte net oop te maak, om jouself beskikbaar te stel, om te help,
yes,
om gebruik te word.
Yes, amen. Yes.
Bruikbaar, nuttig te wees, yes, in God se koninkryk. So ja, sonder om iemand sleg te laat voel oor jou hulp wat jy hom bied.
Yes, and that is very, very, very important. And we must do it with a kind heart, a friendly heart. Yes, amen. When we help others in, whether it is a brother and sister or someone in the world, doesn't matter. You do it wholeheartedly. If you do it wholeheartedly, you are doing it in love.
Jo,
yes.
Praise the Lord.
Sonder om iets terug te verwag. That is so true.
Wow, so
liefde en nederigheid. Yes, Werner, that is right.
Baie mooi. Sure.
And the next one, does not envy. Does not envy. We don't have to say a lot about this, but we are not to envy other what other people have or doesn't have or whatever the case might be. If we are doing what we must do in the gospel, you won't envy anything of someone else, whether they are successful or not, whether they have in the material or not, or spiritual or character or ministry, whatever the case might be, you will not envy that. You won't be jealous towards them.
Sure, is nie jaloers nie.
Yes.
Nou ja, as 'n mens doen wat jy moet doen, as jy nuttig is in God se koninkryk, vervuld is in die evangelie, dan begeer jy nie iets van iemand anders nie. So jy's nie jaloers nie. En ek dink dit is baie keer die grootste probleem in die broederskap ook met mekaar, dat as die een dalk uitstyg volgens jou, dat jy jaloers raak, of jy voel een kry meer aandag as jy, of een word voorgetrek bo jou, of wat ook al die geval mag wees, wat nie so is nie. Dit is net baie keer, en ek dink dit is wat ons baie keer nie verstaan nie, die ou wat homself indruk, wat by is, wat gesels, wat sy saak uitsorteer. Obvious is hy onder die voete. Dit is soos daai kind in jou huis. Daai kind wat onder jou voete is. Ma, pa, sort uit dit, dat. Jy weet die hele tyd van daai kind. Die ander kind lê byvoorbeeld die hele tyd in sy kamer. So jy weet nie die hele tyd van daai kind nie. En dit is hoekom ons baie keer jaloers raak op mekaar. Maar wanneer jy doen wat jy moet doen, en jouself ook indruk en uitsorteer en so aan, gaan jy nie jaloers voel op iemand anders nie.
That is amazing. Now the next point is, English express it so nicely. Does not parade itself.
Wow.
Does not parade itself. No, does not exalt itself. This one and the next point, not puffed up, is basically in the same sentence. I'm gonna explain both of these together. Does not parade itself. In other words, if you look at the parade, you show something outwardly that you are not really. Isn't it so? You brag about your things. That is not to be puffed up. And my wife and myself, we try to find a proper Afrikaans word, but brag is brag.
Yeah,
brag we must brag. Not brag about yourself and yeah. show us and do outward things, visible things, to be counted and to be seen by other people. Well, like the Pharisees, yes. Jesus Christ says, you do are doing all these outward things to be seen. Even
show nie af nie.
Show nie af nie. Daar is die regte Afrikaans ancient.
Show nie af nie. Ja, so liefde praat nie groot nie. So dit roem nie. Dit praat nie groot dinge nie. Dit vergroot nie. En baie keer, ek moes dit nogal baie in my lewe afleer. Is om nie dinge te vergroot nie. Wanneer die situasie plaasgevind het, dan was dit die grootste kar, met die grootste ongeluk, met die grootste ding wat gebeur het, en dan is dit nie eers so nie. Maar om raak gesien te word, wil mens altyd alles exaggerate.
Yes,
en exaggerate. So ja, dit is nogal 'n groot ding. En wat hy ook sê, nie opgeblaas is nie, so jy brek nie. Jy doen nie allerhande uiterlike dinge om raak gesien, om roem te kry, om eer te kry nie. So jy is nederig in God en dis liefde. Wow.
Yes, yes. And even doesn't matter, I'm just thinking of Jesus. A few instances, they challenged him and say, if you are the Son of God, show us a sign, do a miracle. Even Satan said to him, if you are the Son of the God, of God, do this and that. And he didn't brag about the fact that he was the Son of God. He knew he was the Son of God, and he knew that he needed to be humble and serve the Father in meekness and in love, and that love and meekness must show towards the people around him.
Sure, ja, so Jesus was die Seun van God, en hy het vir hom gesê, doen vir my, wat sal teken gaan jy vir ons doen, so dat ons kan glo dat jy die Seun van God is, en hy het geweet. Hy is die Seun van God, maar hy het geweet, hy moet God in nederigheid dien, en hy moet hom soek, en hy moet sy wil doen. So hy het nie op koop geloop daarmee, dat hy die Seun van God is nie, hy het nie daarover gaan brek nie, hy het hom nie self daarover gaan verhoog nie.
Yes.
Hy het altyd geroem in die Vader.
Yes.
Is dit nie mooi nie?
Amen.
Hy was altyd nederig en in die Vader geroem en sy wil gedoen.
Yeah, wow, it doesn't matter, it didn't matter how they challenged him, he always stayed
humble
and geduldig, patiently. Yeah, patient. He was always patiently. Okay, now let's jump over to verse 5. Verse 5 says, does not behave rudely. That rudely is also extravagant. So love does have manners. We must have manners. We must not be extravagant. That comes to the same point more or less, not to parade yourself. So it has manners. You must respect another person as well. Not go with his sin. And this is the problem that we have. Remember, love is holy. Love is pure. Love is righteous. Love is truth. God has no dealings with sin. Doesn't love the world. We must always bear that in mind. But we must have manners. And that is a big thing in the gospel as well. We does not behave rudely or is extravagant.
So, handel nie onwelvoeglik nie. En dit kom weer ook uit, want dit is manierlik, bedagsaam, om nie uitspattig te wees nie. Om nie 'n vertrek vol te maak as jy instap en almal weet van jou en jy vat oor en jy gaan te kere nie. Dis nie om welvoeglik te wees nie. So in die evangelie moet ons sagmoedigheid, nederigheid, liefde, al daai dinge aan mekaar bewys en in nederigheid wandel. Jesus was nie uitspattig gewees nie. Hy het nie homself die hele tyd so geopenbaar as die Seun van God, soos wat ons dalk sou gedoen het.
Geloop en wonderwerke gedoen vir die vertoon.
Vir die vertoon en daai tipe van ding om die aandag op hom te kry nie. Dit was glad nie sy idee gewees nie, want hy het in liefde gewandel vir sy Vader. En dit is so mooi om te dink. So as ons net daar dink, dan dink ons al klaar, Here, hoe tree ons baie keer op? Wat doen ons baie keer? Hoe kom ons baie keer oor? Hoe stel ons onsself bekend? En al daai tipe van dinge, wil jy dadelik die aandag op jouself hê? Of is jy in nederigheid daarom liefde uit te leef?
So, wow, so, that is quite amazing. Yes, to have manners. We must have manners. If we look at Jesus Christ, he never just came into a room and just say what he wanted to say. He was there, he knew his position, he knew what he had to do, and he acted according to that. Now, the next thing, does not seek his own. And I say to my wife, this, I think, sums up the whole, everything of love. Does not seek its own. And that comes to the point of love your neighbor as yourself. And if you do that, you will also love God. So you don't seek your own. You seek God's kingdom. You seek the advancement of his kingdom. It's not about myself. It's about God's kingdom. I minister the gospel. Jesus Christ did everything. He worked every day very hard, and he was in the on the lips and in the minds of everyone while he was on earth. But he did not seek his own glory. He seeked the glory of his Father, because he knew the Father can set people free in his name after his resurrection.
Wow, soek nie sy eie belang nie. As iets oor jouself gaan, dan soek jy jou eie belang.
Yes.
Baie keer het ons eie standpunte, ons eie idees, ons eie geaardheid en dinge wat ons wil afdruk en afforceer.
Yes.
En ons wil baie keer nie die wil van God doen nie. En dit is om jou eie belang te soek. Jy raak, word al kwaad vir mense, yes, omdat jy jou eie belang soek. Jy soek jou eie voordeel. Dis alles, yes, om jou eie, amen, belang te soek. En dis so mooi wat Paula nou hier so sê, mens moet al hierdie dinge sonder om daarvan bewus te wees hê, anders is 'n mens hoogmoedig. So ja, mens kan nie in onopregtheid hierdie pad stap nie, maar mens kan hierdie eienskappe begin aanneem en in opregtheid met God die pad begin stap. En dit is so. Mens, as een mens begin roem daaroor dat jy nederig is, of dat jy nie opgeblaas is of nie, of dat jy nie jaloers is nie, of wat ook al, moet jy al klaar weet, jy het die punt gemis. So jy kan in elk geval in niks roem nie. Jy moet aangaan met die evangelie, die Here soek en dien, en liefde uitleef.
Yes, also Mary says, God's kingdom is order. Yes, it's right. If you're going to read 1 Corinthians 14, it describes this order. We cannot, while I'm ministering, my wife cannot all of a sudden just start singing a song.
Yes.
While I'm ministering, she must wait until I'm done, then she can carry on. That is the order, or the does not behave rudely that the word talks about. So that is quite amazing.
Yeah.
Does not seek its own, so we must not do things to be our own esteem be exalted. Like, he's not provoked. He doesn't get bitter. We don't have to say a lot about that. We must not be bitter towards other as well, because God is not bitter.
Yes, so ons moet nie verbitterd wees nie. Ons moet nie met mense verbitterd raak, want God is nie verbitterd nie. En dat die vergifnis wat in ons harte deurbreek, maak ons los en vry en alles uit gevangenisse uit. En
yes,
maak ons harte los, en dis net liefde. Wow.
Yes, amen. And when he's also in Hebrews 12, he says, there must be no root of bitterness. Because
yeah,
the root of bitterness makes us to fall away, to become sure, cold, to be separated from the Lord. So that is very important, not to be bitter. And if there is bitterness, actively seek the Lord so that you can receive an answer from his word, that he can deliver you from that bitterness.
Yeah, sure. So. Nou, hy sê so mooi, ons moet nie in 'n gal van bitterheid wees nie. En ons moet ons harte en ons lewe uitsorteer. Wanneer ons voel daar's bitterheid in ons lewe, moet ons daadwerklik gaan effort aangaan met dit.
Yes.
Om uit daai bitterheid uit te kom, uit daai gal uit te kom, sodat die Here ons kan verlos daarvan.
Amen. Things no evil. In Afrikaans is reken die kwaad nie toe nie. In other words, whoever does evil, you must not think or ponder it about it and keep it against somebody. You must not keep evil against somebody. If you forget the evil, you won't think evil of other people as well. So this is just because God doesn't think evil.
Yeah.
So we must not think of evil towards other people as well.
Ja, reken die kwaad nie toe nie, hou nie die kwaad nie.
Do not keep book.
Hou nie boek van die kwaad.
That's the other one.
Hou nie boek van die kwaad nie. Hou nie boek van die ander se lewe nie.
Yes, that is the thing. Things no evil. Also, it doesn't keep book of other people's wrong.
Amen.
Does not keep book. We keep book. And
boekhouders.
Yeah, we good spiritual bookkeepers. and the Lord says that if we are bitter towards somebody, we will keep book of the evil they are doing, have done to us, or even to other people as well.
Sure, praise the
Lord. Yes. Now in verse 6, it says, "Doesn't rejoice in iniquity." Now that rejoice means you're not glad. You take pleasure in unrighteousness, and iniquity is sinful things. Now, what is quite amazing, when we read in Ephesians 5 verses 3 to 4, he says, "But fornication and all uncleanliness and covetousness, let it not even be named among you as it is fitting for saints, neither filthiness nor foolish talking nor coarse jesting, which are not fitting, but rather giving thanks." So that rejoicing is, we talk about evil things. We talk about the things of this world, greediness in this world. And the Word of God says we must not even name these things. In other words, we must not be glad. And a while ago we had a sermon, if we keep on talking about things in the world and have conversations about things in the world and say, "Wow, look at a world this and look at a world that," there we exalt the world. We praise the world. Actually, we are glad for the world. We rejoice in what the worldly things, what the world accomplish every day. And he says we must not even name or talk about the sin and the things of this world.
Is hierdie ene nie?
Ja, vers 3 en 4, ja.
Efesiërs 5 vers 3 en 4, maar hoerery en allerhande onreinheid of hebzig moet onder julle selfs nie genoem word nie, soos dat die heiliges betaam, ook nie gemeenheid of dwaase of lawwe praatjies wat nie pas nie, maar liewer danksegging. So dis 'n mooi man te dink dat hy vir ons hierso sê, ons moet nie bly wees by die ongeregtigheid nie. So ons moet nie die wêreld opbou nie. Ons moet nie daaroor bly wees nie. Ons moet dit nie verhoog nie. Wanneer ons baie keer dink aan die lotto of wat ook al, en ons maak grappies daaroor en ons roem daarin en sulke dinge, dit is daai ongeregtigheid waar ons bly is. Ons praat van die wêreld asof dit reg is, asof dit goed is. Ons verhoog dalk iemand in die wêreld wat het. En ons begeer dit baie keer. So jy bou aan die wêreld, aan daai ongeregtigheid. En God sê ons moet dit nie doen nie. Dit moet nie eens in jou mond wees nie. Daai lawwe praatjies, grappies, dingetjies wat niks met God te doen het nie. Ons moet klaar kry met dit, want dis nie liefde nie. Dis afbreekend op God se koninkryk.
Ja, foolish talking, that is a great big thing. Nor coarse jesting, and we ons sê baie keer in die wêreld, "Wow, kyk, daai ding wat hy uitgevind het, Jos, daai ou was maar slim, maar die ding kon hy uitgevind het." What we are doing, we exalting the world. When we proclaim the ingenuity of people in the world, what they discovered, worldly things and things in the world, we actually rejoice in their findings, in their accomplishments. And that is what the Bible says, we must not rejoice in that. And that is a big thing we need to understand. And also sinful things, because the majority of times, the whole worldly system, everything goes hand in hand with sinful things, because it is people that doesn't want to serve the Lord. They are walking in unrighteousness.
Ja, so ons moet niks in die wêreld verhef nie. Geen persoon, geen mens, geen uitvinding, geen niks in die wêreld moet ons verhef nie.
Ja.
So.
Kring van die spotters, yes, wow. Seems to me everybody's understanding this very nicely.
Kring van die spotters, dis sit.
Let's go back a little bit. Hey, it's talking about rejoice in the truth. Yes, what is the truth? The truth of God's word. Jesus Christ is the truth of God. We must have the love of truth. That is what we must rejoice and talk about. And exalt Jesus, exalt the word, exalt God the Father, exalt the truth of God's word. That is what we must talk about, think about, and also give praise about as well. Hallelujah.
Praise die Here. Maar is bly saam met die waarheid. So ons moet in die waarheid bly. Ons moet opgewonde wees oor die woord van die Here. Ons moet dit verkondig. Ons moet dit verhoog. Ons moet God verhoog. Ons moet dit uitdra aan almal. En ons moet bly wees oor die waarheid van die woord. Ons moet dit hoog ag. Wanneer ons dink aan die waarheid van die woord. So dit is net amazing. Ons moet bly wees saam met die waarheid. Nie saam met dit wat in die wêreld is nie.
Says Werner is saying, yeah, we're always talking about the good old days. That's exalting the good old days. There was nothing good about the old days. It was sinful people creating sinful things that yes. oppressed a lot of things. We don't want to go in there, but it's not the good old days. It's about serving the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. That is what we must exalt and encourage each other to look forward to the future, our eternal life, our inheritance in heaven.
Sure. Prys die Here. Ek dink nou aan my man. Baie keer verwys mens na mense wat al dood is.
Yes.
Dit het niks met die lewe te doen nie.
Yes.
En dit is baie keer wil mens daai persoon verhoog en aangaan oor mense en dinge. Dit is dinge wat in elk geval verby is. Dit is verlede, dit is klaar. Ons moet klaar kry met hierdie dinge en ons moet uitstrek na dit wat voor is. Whatever gebeur het, moet ons uitstrek na wat voor is.
So, if I even think about Jesus, he never even exalted even the prophets of the Old Testament.
Sure.
He referred to Moses, but he never exalted him. He referred to Elijah, but he only said something about Elijah according to the fulfillment. And even John the Baptist. Jesus Christ didn't carry on about John the Baptist his whole life. He mentioned the fulfillment of the scripture, and that was the end of it. So he never, ever exalted a human being, wow. even if it was a prophet in the Old Testament.
Ja, so dit is so mooi. Jesus Christus het nie eers die profete in die Ou Testament verhoog nie. Hy het van hulle gepraat. Hy het van Moses, hy het genoem van Moses, hy het genoem van Elia met die vervulling van Johannes. Hy het gesê wie Johannes is, maar hy het nie aangegaan daaroor en mense verhoog nie. So ja, dit is wat ons baie keer doen. Ook in predikers. Mense verhoog baie keer predikers.
So.
En wie moet verhoog word? God moet verhoog word.
So, now there's actually in verse 7, we want to stand still a little bit, I think, just to explain something, because this can be quite confusing. Now, first of all, we're just going to go through the points here in verse 7, but we want to stand still at one point. He says it bears all things, it believes all things, it hopes all things, it endures all things. We must remember, God is holy, His love is holy, it's pure. We must not be glad about unrighteousness, worldly things, etc., but rejoice in the truth. So even in this, bear that in mind. And we want to elaborate a little bit more on bear all things.
So in verse 7, lees ons het bedek alles, glo alles, hoop alles, verdra alles. So as ons nou net na God se liefde kyk, dan is dit rein, heilig, sonder sonde, sonder ongeregtigheid, is blysaam met die waarheid en al die dinge. En ons wil net die punt van dit bedek alles, wil ons dalk net so bietjie bespreek, want dit kan so bietjie confusion skep.
And the English Bible is talking about bear all things. It means to cover with silence. That's why the Afrikaans word is using the word cover all things. So it's endure patiently. Now, does it mean to ignore? There's a difference between covering and ignore. And I think this is the confusion we have in the whole concept of God's love according to the scripture.
Yes, so bedek alles beteken om stil te bly oor dinge.
Yes.
Nou beteken dit dat mense dit ignoreer, asof dit nie bestaan nie.
Yes.
Nee, dit gaan glad nie daaroor nie. So ons gaan net so lekker daar gesels.
Yes, so let us look at cover all things, bedek alles, cover all things, bear all things. Does it mean to ignore? Now, ignoring means to ignore the reality or the existence of something that are still there. Ignoring means it's there, but you ignore it. Sometimes we say, my child is ignoring me. You are talking to him, but she is just ignoring you. The situation is still there, but you ignore it. Doesn't mean it is covered.
Yeah, so bedek beteken nie om te ignoreer nie, want om te ignoreer beteken, dit is nog daar, maar jy ignoreer dit. Jy, hoe kan ek dit nou sê? Jy vermy dit eintlik. So die situasie is daar, maar jy vermy dit. Jy gaan net verby dit. So dit is nie bedek nie, dit is nie weg nie.
Yes.
Maar jy gaan aan asof dit nie meer daar is nie.
Now, quite amazing, it uses the word cover or bedek in Afrikaans. Now, there's a certain reason why this word gets used. Because if you cover something, it is as if it's not there. Okay? Ignore means it's there, but you just refuse to do something about it. Now, the analogy or the symbolism of the word cover is to show us that when something is covered, it is as good as it is that it doesn't exist. Yeah. Okay?
Yes, so as jy dink aan bedek, dan is dit so goed soos dit bestaan nie meer nie, dis weg. Maar wanneer jy dit net ignoreer, dan is dit nog daar, maar jy weier om dit te herken.
Yes, okay. Now to understand this a little bit more, let us read James 5, verse 19 and 20. James 5, verses 19 and 20.
Kan ek maar hier so lees?
Jebo, yes, ek kan maar daar voortgaan.
19 and 20.
Yes. Brethren, if anyone among you wanders from the truth. Wow, that's quite amazing. Wanders from the truth. We must rejoice in the truth. So if we wander away from the truth, we don't rejoice in the truth anymore. Wow, it's amazing. A wander from the truth. And someone turns him back. Let him know that he who turns a sinner from the error of his way will have a soul from death, will save a soul from death, and cover a multitude of sins. But here we can see, it's in a certain context. There's a certain, ek het die woord gehad, voorwaarde. Ach, liever, no, that was before we started the service.
Voorwaarde.
Condition. There's a condition, and this is how we're going to understand what it means that to cover a multitude of sins. Now, if you are start reading from verse 13, okay, from verse 13, he's talking here of a brother in Christ going to his brethren, his fellow brothers, acknowledging and confessing his sins in the teenwoordigheid, presence of his fellow brothers, confessing his sins, and they pray for him so that he can be healed. Now, this is the context. And at the end of the day, he says here, if somebody has wandered from the truth and turned that brother back. In other words, you were in a position to help a brother who turned their back against the truth to come back to the Lord. Now, in the time when he wandered away and were under sin, fell under sin once again, he did a multitude of sins. And when he confessed his sins, the sins were forgiven. And that is what that covering means, to cover a multitude of sins. Because he did a multitude of sins before he confessed. Now he has confessed his sins. His brothers prayed for him, and God healed him and restored him. And now his sins that were numerous sins are covered. In other words, it's forgiven. It's gone. It doesn't exist anymore.
Ek dink dit is so lekker, die punt het oorgekom van bedek alles hier by 1 Korintiërs 13 nie. Wil dit net gou so vinnig vir jy vertel.
Okay, okay, okay.
Want by 1 Korintiërs 13 vers 7 sê hy, dit bedek alles. So, ignoreer jy net iemand se sonde, keer jy iemand se sonde goed, sien jy dit net oor of wat ook al. Nou wat hy hier vir ons probeer sê is, jy bly stil oor iemand se sonde, al weet jy, van iemand se sonde, ongeregtigheid of wat ook al die geval mag wees. Gaan praat jy nie daaroor nie. Jy gaan skinder nie daaroor nie. Jy het nie 'n kwaad praat sessie daaroor nie. So dit is liefde om dit vir jouself te hou. So jy bedek dit in daardie opsig. Jy gaan nie te koop met iemand se sonde of ongeregtigheid nie. So dit ek wil dit net daar vir ons so punt daar deurbring. En dan gaan ons na Jakobus 5. So is allemaal by ons daar met daai bedek van sondes.
Yes.
Jakobus 5 vers 19 en 20. Hy sê, broeders, as een onder julle van die waarheid afgedwaal het en iemand hom bekeer, laat hy weet dat die een wat 'n sondaar van sy dwaalweg bekeer, 'n siel uit die dood sal red en 'n menigte sondes sal bedek. So hier praat hy van 'n menigte sondes word bedek. Nou, hoe moet ons dit verstaan? Hy het hier na die ouderlinge toe gekom, hierdie persoon, en hy het sy sonde kon bely en uitgesorteer, so hy kon gehelp word, hy kon ontsla raak van hy sonde wat hy gedoen het.
Yes.
En nou het hy basies tot bekering gekom, wie hy het, wie is hy saak uitgesorteer, die sonde wat hy gedoen het, is nou weggewas, hy het kom bely, hy het kom uitsorteer. So nou is die menigte, die klomp sonde, is nou bedek, want hy het dit kom uitbring, hy het kom uitsorteer. So nou is dit bedek. So jy as bedienaar, of ouderling, of diaken, of wat ook al, het die persoon gehelp, met dit wat in sy binneste was, waarmee hy gesukkel en geworstel het, wat hy probeer wegsteek het, maar toe kom hy maar eerder uit met sy saak, en hy sê, dis wie ek is, en ek gaan my eerder van my dwaalweg bekeer, en ek gaan my hart uitsorteer, gaan my sonde bely, en my hart weer vir die Here uitsorteer en so aan, dan word die sonde, wat die persoon gedoen het, tot op die oomblik, bedek. Dit word weggewas, dit, God maak klaar daarmee, hy weg, dit was dit weg, hy vergewe dit, so enige sonde, wat vergewe is, deur God, is bedek, deur God.
Yes, wow, that is quite amazing, because, and the main thing is, we as children of God, we must remember now, this brother who fell away from the truth, came to his fellow brothers. Now they sorted the things out. This brother confessed his sins. He really repented. Remember, he didn't come to spiritual rebirth once again. He just repented from his ways as a brother in Christ. Now, as soon as that situation are finished, the brother is back on the road, there he carries on. Everybody must cover. Everybody must forget the sin of the brother that he confessed. So if somebody comes to me and trust me and he confessed and I pray with him and he trust me, I must walk away and not remember his sin anymore. That is when I must practice, I must cover all things. So I must cover that brother. I must be there not to talk about the sin that he came to me to help him with. This is our, I must not walk away and talk about these wrongdoings.
Ja, so dis baie mooi. Wanneer iemand aan jou toe kom vir hulp en bely sy sonde en so aan en kom weer terug na die Here toe en daai sonde word bedek deur God wat vergewe is, moet jy as kind van die Here nie daaroor gaan praat nie. Jy moet nie daaroor gaan skinder nie. Jy moet hy gaan sê, weet jy wat het in daai broer se lewe gebeur? En so en wat en dit en dat nie. Jy moet dit vergeef. Jy moet klaarmaak daarmee. Jy moet dit bedek asof dit nooit gebeur het nie. Asof jy dit nooit eers gehoor het nie. Asof dit nie eers bestaan het nie. Want God het dit vergewe en jy moet dieselfde daaroor voel. Dis weg, dis klaar, dis verby.
Yes, now the main thing is, when we talk about God, God's love, remember love, God is love, and we are talking about God's love. So how does a person feel bad about his sin? God, through his spirit, convicts that person. God does not ignore us. He keeps on talking to us through the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. And he impresses on us that we must sort out our sin. But, say for instance, I have a problem in my life. God start talking to me first and foremost. If I ignore what the Lord is talking to me, then God might just inspire another brother and sister to come and talk to me or give me a message so that I can understand the reality of what I'm busy with so that I can repent. So God does not ignore our sin. He talks to us about our sin. And if we ignore it, then God might just use somebody to come and speak directly to us. So there's a difference between covering and ignoring. I just want to sort this out. And we must have that love of God in our hearts as well. So if we see a brother doing or at fault or in error, we are allowed to speak to that brother, but in the love of God always.
Sure, is dit nie mooi nie? So God praat altyd met ons oor ons sonde. God ignoreer nie ons sonde nie. Ons kan dit nie vir God wegsteek nie. Dis nie asof dit nie bestaan het as ons gesondig het nie. Maar God bly ons oortuig deur sy gees, om werk te maak met daai sonde, om te vergifnis te kom vra, so dat dit bedek kan word, vergewe kan word. Sê, is dit nie mooi nie, maar wanneer die mens baie keer hardkoppig is, of alsterrig is, en jy kry nie klaar met daai sonde nie, jy sorteer dit nie uit nie, en dis nou waar die liefde in ons as kinders van die Here se harte moet wees, om die woord te bly bedien, asof God dit bedien, om te vermaan, asof God vermaan. So in daai liefde, want jy moet nie bitterheid teen 'n broer of 'n suster, wat dalk sonde gedoen het, en jy moet nie in bitterheid na hom toe gaan, en hom gaan reghelp nie. Jy moet in liefde na daai persoon toe gaan, en dis wat die woord sê, so mooi, moenie verbitterd raak nie. Want hoe vinnig kan 'n mens verbitterd raak, as jy sien, iemand doen iets verkeerd. Nou in daai liefde moet jy die evangelie bly bedien, jy kan dalk daai persoon gaan waarsku, met hom praat, die woord vir hom voorhou, mooi met hom gesels en sê, dit is die saak, en jy moet jou saak uitsorteer en soaan. So jy mag met iemand praat en gesels, om daai saak uit te sorteer. Jy hoef dit nie te ignoreer nie, maar wanneer jy van iets weet, moet jy nie te koop loop daarmee nie. Jy moet nie daai persoon gaan sleg maak nie, of daai persoon hom nou bekeer, en of daai persoon hom nie bekeer nie. Jy het nie die reg om oor daai persoon se sonde en ongeregtigheid te gaan praat nie.
Ja, even the sinner, we have a tendency and we take it upon ourselves to speak about sinners' sinful life. And we, that is not what the Lord doesn't go around and talk to us all the time about everybody's sin. He convicts everybody. We see the sin. Then we walk with bitterness in our own life. And what do? We go and talk to everybody about a certain person or persons or the sinner's sin. And that is not love. When you are in a situation to talk to a person about something, you talk it, you walk away, you forget it. This is the true love of God, and this is how He is working with us. So He's not ignoring our sin. He's convicting us of our sin. But we ignore it and think, now God ignores us because I ignore it. No, God doesn't ignore it. That's why we feel bad all the time about our sin in our lives.
Tjo, is dit nie mooi nie. So God oortuig ons die hele tyd van ons sonde om dit uit te sorteer. Hy ignoreer nie ons sonde nie. Maar ons as kinders van die Here moet, en ons praat vandag so daarvan, dat dis wat hy sê, jy moet jou naaste lief hê soos jouself. Jou naaste is jou broers, jou susters, in die Here en die sondaar. So jy kan ook nie van die wêreld gaan skinder. Baie keer voel die mense jy die reg om oor die wêreld te praat. Jy kan verbitterd raak oor die wêreld. Wat mense doen in die wêreld, wat die persoon, het jy nou weer dit gesien, het jy nou weer dat gesien, het jy nou weer dit gehoor, het jy dat gehoor, en dit is baie keer, ons voel ons het 'n reg, omdat dit 'n sondaar is. Nie eers met dit nie, jy moet dit bedek met liefde. Jy kan vir daai persoon gaan bid, en dis wat die woord so mooi sê, as jy jou broeder sien sondig, gaan bid vir hom. So wat doen jy? Jy bedek sy sonde. Nie sy sonde omdat dit reg is nie, maar omdat jy nie daaroor gaan praat en gaan dit jou verlustig daarin en gaan skinder daaroor nie. Jy verstaan, Here, hierdie broer of suster moet loskom van hierdie sonde. Dis die liefde van jou in jou hart. Dis God se liefde in jou hart. Here, ek moet werk maak daarvan. Ek moet regtig vir my broer of my suster bid en hom nie gaan swart smeer nie.
Yes, and if we talk about other people's sin all the time, we can minister a gospel like you want to. This is what he says in the beginning. We are a sounding, a clanging cymbal and a sounding brass. Sure. And that's why sometimes our gospel doesn't have authority and power, because we are willfully walking with things in our life without understanding what is God's real life. And he wants to help us.
Yeah.
He wants to sort our heart out. If you feel, Lord, what is standing in the way? Sort it out and say, Lord, this is my situation. I understand something. I maybe have a love for the world. I maybe have bitterness. I'm toxic. I talk about other people's things, etc., etc. So that is things that are breaking the law, the royal law of love. And we are standing guilty then, even as a child of God, we are standing guilty then as a sinful person.
Sure. Dit is so mooi om aan te denk. Dit is God se liefde.
Yes.
En ons moet dit so verstaan en ons moet dit so uitleef. Anders breek ons die koninklike wet af. En dis 'n groei proses. Ek kan vir jy sê, dis 'n groei proses. Ons hoor vanaand die woord. En ons moet dit aanneem en dan begin jy dit toepas. En soos jy dit toepas, so begin dit groei in jou hart.
Yes,
en as 'n mens weet sien as jy los van skinder en kwaad praat en al die dinge, want ons klassifiseer sonde. Ons voel die oorreder gaan hel toe, maar ek wat kwaad praat is self wat van die oorreder praat. Nee. Jy gaan na dieselfde hel toe, want wat sê die woord? Die oorreder en die kwaadspreker gaan nie God se koninkryk in nie. So ons moet vanaand dit verstaan en deel maak van ons lewe en wanneer 'n mens dit nie kan hanteer nie, bly weg van mense se lewe af.
Yes.
Dit is, weet jy wat maak mense onrustig? Wanneer mense op Facebook gaan kyk wat mense almal nou doen, wat almal gepost het, waarmee almal besig is, op almal se status of wat ook al, dan begin dit woel hier binne in jou. Dit begin bitterheid raak, dit begin seer raak, dit begin jaloers raak. En al daai dinge, groei in die Here, groei in daai liefde en so gaan jy loskom en so gaan jy vrykom en kan begin besef, Here, ek kan nie in bitterheid aangaan nie. Ek kan nie in kwaadspreek aangaan nie. Ek kan nie in jaloesie aangaan nie. En so gaan jy loskom en vrykom van al hierdie dinge en dan kan jy daai koninklike wet uitleef, loof die
Here. Wow, we don't want to be a transgressor of the royal law, hallelujah. And it's quite amazing when we read in Romans 4 verse 7, he says, blessed is the man whose lawless deeds are forgiven and whose sins are covered. That's Romans 4 verse 7. And yeah, he referred back to Psalm 32, that he said, when I didn't confess my sins, when I tried to ignore it, when I tried to hide it from the Lord, in myself, I felt this groaning, I felt this darkness, this trouble in me. It was like a fire burning in me. But when I confessed it, and we must confess it, and then the Lord will forgive us. That's how our sins are forgiven, covered, out of the way. And we as human beings must not talk to each other or to someone else about someone's weakness.
Ja, is mooi. Romeine 4 vers 7. Welglik salig is hulle wat se ongeregtighede vergewe en wie se sondes bedek is. So hoe word jy vergewe? Deur die belydenis van jou sonde. So wanneer 'n persoon dit gaan ophaal of weer gaan uit daar gaan praat of daar gaan skinder of wat ook al, is dit 'n geweldige saak vir die volgende persoon. So welglik salig is die persoon wat sy ongeregtigheid vergewe is. Gelukkig is daai persoon. Want die woord van die Here sê so mooi in Psalm, hy sê wanneer ek my sonde weerhou, wanneer ek dit nie bely nie, wanneer ek dit toehou, dan rus die hand van God swaar op my. En dis wat ons baie keer ervaar in ons lewe.
Yes.
Ons voel baie keer daai swaarheid, daai depressie, daai gat van ons lewe, daai bitterheid en onvergewensgesindheid en dinge omdat jy self daarin bly lewe. En dis wat die Here vanaand vir ons leer. Maak jou hart oop, maak jou lewe oop. Bely jou sonde, ongeregtighede sodat jou sonde bedek kan word. En wanneer jy ander ook teekom dat jy nie oor hulle sonde en ongeregtigheid en dinge praat en bemoei siek en praat, daai boodskap van bemoei siek en praat siek het my so losgemaak om te besef, Here, mens praat so. Jy kry net die geringste gap, dan gaan hy mond van jou.
Yes.
En dis wat die Here ons leer. Raak stil.
Yes, I go and read also Psalm 32. When the hand of the Lord is heavy upon us, we feel that heaviness. But we must sort out and we must come to the Lord and reveal ourselves. We must come in the open and reveal ourselves. Reveal our wrongdoings and reveal our ongehoorsaamheid, our disobedience. Reveal it, say, Lord, so many times I received something that I must do. I know I must do this thing. But for years and months and weeks, I've been disobedient to do what you instructed me. And that is why you feel like the hand of the... That's why sometimes we don't even feel there is hope.
Yeah.
Because we don't do the one thing that our Lord expects of us to do. We ignore it. It's not covered. It's not the way. We cannot ignore and wish things away. We must confess. We must come to the Lord. Bring it to the open up your heart towards Him so that He can start forgiving you and that a change in your life can start to take place.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Ja, dit is 'n vryheid.
Yes, amen.
En dit is net 'n daad wat jy moet doen. Dis net 'n gehoorsaamheid wat jy moet toepas. En baie keer wil mens dinge ignoreer. Jy voel ook God moet ook vergeet. Ag, Here, dit was nou nie so erg, vergeet dit nie.
Ja, ja.
Maar God se hand gaan swaar op jou bly rus tot jy dit uitsorteer.
So, wow,
praise die Here. Kom aan, antwoord gekry vanaand.
Yes, amen.
Dis 'n heerlikheid. Ja, om lief te wees soor te hoor. Kan ek vir sê, maak 'n mens se hart geweldig los. Ja. En sit baie verantwoordelikheid op 'n mens.
Yeah, it makes you tremble inside to understand, Lord, you really helped us this evening and open up your word once again and remind us so that we can sort out our life with the Lord.
Hallelujah. Ek dink Kathleen het iets gevra, amper soos 'n persoon wat vergifnis vir jou kom vra oor iets wat hy teen jou gedoen het en jy vergewe hom, bedek dit.
Yes.
Yes.
Dit is presies so.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
Die Here soek en in die gewoonte oefen, prys die
Here. And we talk about other people's lives. Because we want to exalt ourselves. We want to parade ourselves. We want to brag about ourselves. We want to exalt it. Look at that person's fault. I don't have that fault. That is, now I think now we can understand that the whole love of God is so entwined and interweaved with each other. You cannot actually loosen the one from the other one. Sure. If you are doing the one, you're doing everything. If you're breaking the one, you are breaking everything. Ja, and that is what James is talking about.
Ja, dit is so baie keer dan verhoog jy jouself om van 'n ander ou sleg te praat. Want ek is nou nie so sleg soos daai ou nie. En dit is hoe jy jouself verhoog en in jouself roem en brag en al hierdie dinge. En joh, dit het vanaand so diep in my hart gepraat om net te dink, Here, nederigheid, vernedering, uitsorteer, verstaan.
Yes, amen.
Wow.
Yes, so we're going to practice the, and now it is the road of practice, of doing,
wow.
The royal law.
En dit is so erg, baie keer, dat as 'n mens nie van ander mense praat nie, het jy al agtergekom, daar is nie geselskap nie?
Niks.
Daar is nie 'n gesprek as mense nie oor mense praat nie.
So.
En dit is wat ons ook moet, jy moet nie ongemaklik voel met stilte nie.
Yes.
Dan het jy niks om te sê nie. Dan praat jy nie, jy bly stil. Anders praat jy iets produktief oor die woord van die Here.
Yes.
Maar net om te praat, om wat praat is en om in te wees, dis nie liefde nie.
Yes, we must talk and exalt the word and talk about the word. And,
ja.
Once I thought to myself, Lord, if I don't want to say, if I'm not talking to you or something in a word towards somebody else, then I must be silent.
Yes, want wat wil mens sê?
Yes.
Wat kan mens anders sê as om oor mense te praat? Ja. Sure.
Amen. May you have a blessed evening. Wow, amazing. Joch, the time just flew this evening.
Jo,
1.5 hours. Hier. Can't believe it. Jo. It really felt like I was talking 10, 15 minutes.
Joch, prys die Here.
Amen.
Dankie, dit het my vry gemaak vanaand.
Prys die
Here. Dis so cool.
Yes.
Wat ek is almal kan vanaand sê, Here, U maak ons vry. Want as dit kan verstaan, is die res van die evangelie maklik.
Yes.
Dis die moeilike deel. Okay, julle moet 'n lekker aandjie. Ons sien mekaar Vrydagoggend as die Here se wil nabei is, maar ons hou jou op hoogte.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.